Sustainable agriculture certainly is nothing new, but the interest in quantifying sustainability is relatively recent. The ability of NISA to capture the changes that agriculture has already made over multiple generations is very important in providing them a communications strategy to be able to show off the advancements that have been made over time. The NISA guiding principles include, most importantly, that it's producer-led first, that it's verifiable, that someone else can look at it and account for the fact that it's worth doing, that it's science-based, and that we take into account that region and crop-specific solutions are very important.
Agriculture is an important part of the rural communities. We live and recreate in the areas, we're on school boards, etc. Also, we are a large economic foundation that we spend money, equipment, land, property taxes, also hire employees, and we're in it not just for 6 months a year, but for generally for decades. But it's a foundation of communities. When NISA started, I was very happy to engage because one of its goals was to be producer-led and to bring one voice for agriculture, a voice that is not for a specific commodity, a region, or size of scale, but just overall voice for agriculture.
NISA understands the approach that we must look at the entire farm, not just focus on one commodity within that production scheme, but look at our overall efforts, and that we want to get our message across that yes, we're doing everything every day to improve and to push sustainability. Those are things we wake up here every day, so when we leave this land and we pass it on to the next generation, they will find it in better shape and a better place than what we found it ourselves.
I look at NISA as a window, if you will, to my operation. A few years ago, I had a picnic on the farm. I invited all the neighbors just to come into my operation and see how I do things and why I do certain things. To that aspect, I look at NISA doing essentially the same thing on a broader basis.
And that's what this is all about, to try to make everybody see how hard this is to do. You can't just say, cut your fertilizer, cut this, and then you'll be sustainable, because that's not the way, in my opinion, to be sustainable. You must have grower participation at a high level.
When someone would ask me, another producer would ask me, how does NISA fit into my farm or another person's, I would say that It lets you justify the good things that you're doing on your farm today. It also communicates to a consumer the good things that you're doing. And it should show you in a very painless way and non-burdensome way to show you the ways you could improve it more.
It's exciting because since our inception, we've always incorporated sustainability into our farming operations. We've taken care of the land that we grow on. We treat our employees well. We're very efficient with our resources, and nobody's better to tell that story than the growers. And so NISA being grower-driven and producer-led is the best way to move this initiative forward. So we have two choices. We can take a proactive approach, get involved, use and lend our experience, our knowledge, to drive this in a way that it makes sense for the growers and satisfies the needs of the customers, or we can sit back and wait and let it be mandated in a way that doesn't make sense to us.